Right, guys, welcome to the next weekly market breakdown. I'm going to turn this music off. That was just for Joey. Just wait for the chorus. All right, let's get down to business. Okay, so the funny thing is, actually, after asking you guys to do that last night, I definitely did not expect quite a move to occur on DXY. Last night, so as you can see, big rejection off the lows, quite a lot of bullish pressure, and it'll be interesting to see where this thing kind of ends up today. Obviously we've had some minor structure breaks, and I say minor because there's a new rule that I've been kind of looking at which might help you, needs a little bit of back testing, but how to determine the swing highs and the swing lows, right? And what I've been looking at essentially is for it to count as a new, so in this example, new lower highs and a new lower high, and therefore a new potential leg and a swing that we want to look at or focus on, is what we would need is, ideally we would need four candles that would fail to break the most recent low. Okay, so what I mean by that, let me just try and draw this for you as much as possible. So let's just say we have a bearish market. I'm not going to change the colors just because that'll just take some time. But let's say we have a bearish market and then we have this low punched in here, right? The next candle doesn't break the low. The next candle doesn't break the low. The next candle doesn't break the low. And then finally, the fourth candle also doesn't break this low. Okay, this is a low that I'm talking about. This now is enough to consider a leg. Now, again, I haven't tested this too much. It's just something I've been looking at to try and help you guys understand when something is a solid structure, as opposed to being a, just a retracement that we can't really count as a leg, okay? So therefore, because this low, okay, was not broken within the next 4 hours, okay, that means that this is now potentially a new swing, right? And if we're in an overall bearish market like this, then what we're looking for is we're looking for the market to find those sellers again to take that market lower. Now, when it does find those sellers, again, I do apologize for the colors, but it'll just be quicker for me to do it this way. So when it does find those sellers again, okay, this is enough to consider as our new swing, okay, especially when we break that low. Okay, when we break that low from here, this is now our new swing point, right? So this is our new swing point that we'll be looking and focusing on, that if we break that, then potentially things have changed in the near term, okay? So if we have, for example, bearish moves, then we have one candle, we have two candle, we have maybe three candle, and then here, because there's only three candles, okay, I'm not gonna class that as a swing. Okay, I'm gonna class whatever happened up here, let's just say it was here, I'm gonna class this one as my swing, because this isn't significant enough, because there wasn't enough price action behind it, right? So hopefully that makes sense. Now, if we put that into perspective here, okay, this is our low, then we had one candle, two candle, three candle, four candle, that's fine, okay? Which means that this is our swing point, all right? This would be our swing point. We then went and made a new low, okay? So we made a high here, we made a new low here, then we had one candle, but then we broke the low. Then we had one candle, broke the low. Then we had one candle here, okay? Didn't break the low, second candle didn't break the low, third candle didn't break the low, but then the fourth one did. So really, for me, this here is not necessarily a swing point, okay? And you can kind of see it, if you actually zoom out, you're not gonna draw your swing points like this. Okay, because it's too jaggedy, some of these are not really crucial. This is crucial, and we can see that quite clearly, that this area here, this high and this high, are pretty crucial. Okay, this one that I've just marked out there, that is also a solid swing point, because you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 candles that were unable to break this low down here. Okay, unable to break this low down here. So just something I've been looking at, and hopefully that will help you guys. So again, we've got a low punched here. We then have one candle where we don't, two candle where we don't, but then the third candle we do. So that means I wouldn't count this one as a swing point. OK, okay? Not as an overall massive change of bias swing point, okay? So maybe just have a little experiment with that. It might just help you clear up what the difference is between a small retracement and an actual swing and potential change of direction in price. Now, the difference with this one here is, yep, we've broken this one, but as I said, I don't really consider that as an important one. This one, I don't really consider that as an important one. And this one, we've got 1, 2, 3 before it's broken. So even this one, I don't really consider that as being bullish. Okay, we've rejected it anyway. We haven't actually broken it and closed. But this one here and this one here does become the important points. Okay, these ones here, this is kind of like my swing point, okay, for DXY right now to actually consider potential bullish moves on this market, yeah? Anyway, enough drawing. So let's get started. And what I'm gonna do is I am going to be sitting around on Telegram, members. And I'm gonna be going through the pairs that you guys have mentioned here, so that we can kind of do this weekly analysis together. And if you like this kind of concept of you guys showing me what your thoughts are and then me kind of analyzing it myself and comparing the two, then I'm more than happy to do that for you as well. So it'll just make this a little bit more interactive, so that hopefully, rather than just sitting there listening to my voice, you can actually sit there to have your analysis analyzed, checked over, and compared with perhaps what I see. And it doesn't mean that I'm always right. I always mention this to you, because at the end of the day, all we can do is analyze these markets, and the market is going to do its thing. Okay, so let's start off with, so the first person that responded to this was Fungi. Okay, so EC a bit tricky. I'm saying bearish, broke a 4-hour swing low, which gives me more confidence that it's heading down. And the weekly analysis, so overall EC tricky but bearish, and I think you sent another one last week, had a rejection, quite a rejection too. Okay, so Fungi's overall bias on Eurocad is bearish. So let's have a jump on Eurocad, and let's just jump onto the weekly time frame, just to try and make sure that this speeds up as much as possible. Okay. Right. So first things first, we do have a bullish candle last week, but as Fungi, as you said, we did have quite the rejection, okay, and we had quite that rejection from, I'm going to use lines now because it's a little bit cleaner. We had, I guess, if we were to think about order blocks on the weekly, again, I don't really worry about these too much, but we're certainly rejecting, right? We're certainly rejecting this kind of area. Price is being held up at that 1.37 region. And also, we've got clearly a lot of liquidity around this region, right? And this is where sellers are coming into the market, between 1.37 and 1.38, roughly speaking, okay? So overall, would I also be bearish? Yes, I would, okay? Yes, I would. And mainly because the rejection that came through last week at the significant point, but I certainly would be wary of the fact that we actually did, you know, buyers have been in control for about 2 weeks, so I would be wary of that. Okay, that's just one thing to be aware of. So what do we do first? We mark on the weekly low, previous weekly low, and we mark on the previous weekly high. Okay, so anyone that's bullish on this market is going to be looking for that to push up and attack this kind of 1.38 level. Anyone that's bearish should be looking for that to head down and attack that 1.3540 level. Okay, that's the first simple bit of analysis that you need to do. Okay, understand where the market could be attacking. Okay, similar to this, look, bearish candle. What happened the next week? We retraced all the way back up to this region, but did we tap into the weekly liquidity? Yes, we did. The next one was a bullish candle. Okay, we had a rejection off of a nice low. And then what do we see? And we see the market retrace a bit before then attacking this high. Okay, so I also wouldn't be against buying Eurocad. Okay, especially if we get that continued weakness on DXY. Okay, I wouldn't be against that. And like I say every single week, like there's opportunities to be buying and selling, but only when you're more experienced should you be doing that. Okay, so weekly time frame, nice and simple, nothing really to worry about or focus on too much. So down to the daily time frame. Okay, we've already had a significant rejection from this 1.3750. Okay, so this here is clearly our liquidity, right? It's clearly our liquidity. So let's just tap that in. So we've jumped into liquidity last week, and now we are pushing to the downside. So my target, okay, if I was short in this market, okay, my target on this market would be this level, probably here, okay, somewhere between these two here. Let's just narrow it down to this daily one here. So this would be my target, okay, and we can highlight the whole candle if we want to, but that would be my target of where I potentially like to see EuroCAD falling into. After that, okay, after that, I'd again be a little bit wary because we did have that bullish candle that we could just be tapping into the liquidity on that weekly low, and then we could actually find the pressure to push up, but that's probably not going to happen all in 1 week. But otherwise, bearish pressure is to the downside. Look at the low, the highs, okay, they're not breaking. Every single day, they're not breaking. Every single day, they're just pushing lower, lower high, lower low, lower high, lower low, lower high, lower low. And that's what you'll see if you go down in the time frames as well. So I think a good target for this, is this kind of 1.3550 level for short positions on this market. If we go down to the 4 hour, let's just see if there's anything else. Okay, target wise, we've kind of done that now, that's all good. In terms of opportunities, so where could we look at actually selling this market? There's no real obvious order blocks in here. We've got this big wick and this big wick here. So this would probably be going down into the hourly time frame, being very, very patient, I'd imagine, and waiting for, you know, some sort of test of this 1.3650 level. Now, we might not get it. We've also got a couple of little hourly order blocks going on here as well, so we can watch the price around this point. And that's where we would want to be if we're looking at shorting this market. Okay, that's where we would be. Yeah, where we'd want to be. Now, if you do decide you're long on this market and you wanted to go long, okay, one, you need to wait for this region, and then two, you need to wait for bullish order flow. Okay, right now we're in bearish order flow. Okay, we have pushed down, made a slight new low, came back up, grabbed the sellers from this candle here, or maybe even this one here, and then we pushed and we made another new low. We've come back up, we haven't quite reached the order blocks or the liquidity, but then we pushed down again. What's happened again? A little bit of a range yesterday before actually pulling back up into this region, which is this last candle here, and then actually pushing down into the lows and now continuing that bearish order flow. Okay, so I think targets 1.357 to 1.3550 is a sensible target. Entries, I'd have to see, personally, I'd have to see that market kind of flip back up into these regions to find that opportunity. But we'll wait and see what happens. But otherwise, Fungi, I would agree with you in saying that that is a good piece of analysis, that your weekly bias is on point, as long as you're aware that last week was a bullish candle, and therefore you do want to be a little bit careful at this point, because this is where the market can turn. Okay, so we can mark that as bearish, but remember, get to this point, we just need to be careful. Okay, we do need to be careful when we get to this point. We then have, let's have a quick look whilst I go through this. Okay, so Zenup with Germany. Okay, so bullish on DAX. This is the area on the daily that I like for buyers, and a pullback to the last bearish daily. Correct. A bit more refined on the 4 hour. Yep, I like that as well. And the same kind of area on the 1 hour. Exactly. Okay, so let's just jump on DAX and let's go on to the weekly first of all. So last week was a very bullish week. Last week was a very bullish week. Let me just clear these off. Last week was a very bullish week. We got very unlucky with one position as well. So first of all, where are we now? Okay, we're at a point of liquidity. Okay, so that's something to be aware of. We've also broken last week's high. So I'm just gonna mark on last week's low. And last week's high is pretty much marked on anyway, so that's fine. So yeah, bullish candle pushing all the way up to here. I'd also mark this level, okay, because it's kind of significant for me to potentially see pullbacks into that 14,250 levels. But if we do look on here, I think, 14,200 is roughly where you're looking anyway, so that's fine. On the daily time frame, we're seeing that strong bullish momentum. Now, we've got that liquidity. We've also got this order block right here, which is currently where we're sitting at. So that's, again, something to be aware of. But with this kind of high being made, new low, new high, we can kind of expect that market to come down into this sort of region around here. Would be really nice, into about there. So all I'm doing here is just covering those wicks. So that would be anywhere from 14,290 down to 14,160 would be good positions to look for longs on DAX. Okay, so pretty much spot on in terms of analysis. Zena is one of our probably most patient traders. So whether or not we actually, you know, get these levels to trade from, we will have to wait and see, but we certainly can't rule it out because this is DAX and DAX can move quite strongly at times. Okay, so overall spot on. I'd be looking for the same kind of thing in terms of buying this market. I would like to see a bit more of a drop before we even consider it, because we're quite high at the moment, right? So even if we consider this as a leg, which on the 4 hour I wouldn't, but based on the rule that I mentioned earlier, would that count? 1, 2, 3, 4. So yeah, we've had four candles, okay, which means that this for me is that leg, which is roughly where we're kind of heading to anyway. So even if we look at the sort of premium versus discount aspect, okay, what we'll see here is we'll see the 50% zone being about 14,400. So we do really want to see that market pull down into those levels before even considering, you know, trading off of maybe 1 hour order blocks here, 1 hour order block here, but ideally this level down here. So overall bullish, overall the bias that Zenat's done is perfect. I'd be doing the same thing. It's just a waiting game to see if we get that opportunity come through on DAX. Okay, so well done, Zena. Let's just scroll through. So now we've got CAD CHF. I hope it's correct, he says. Joey, there's no wrong or right. So there's no wrong or right answers. So just remember that it's literally just a game of understanding what you're seeing, and then letting the markets do its thing. Okay, and being patient, waiting for that as well. So let's just compare. So CAD CHF. So you're giving the hourly chart there. You've got the recent high. You've got the recent low. Okay, let me just put this on first. Okay, so we've got. I would mark this point first. So this is a CAD CHF is a tricky one. It's actually one of my least favorite markets. That Euro CHF as well. I like Euro GBP, but it's one of my sort of most boring markets, to be completely honest with you. But anyway, there's the high, there's the low. Okay, so the first thing to note is quite the rejection last week. Actually, is that the full? Yeah, sorry, it's the full candle. Let me just delete this. Yeah, okay. So we do have a nice rejection last week, okay, from these kind of levels where we actually propelled and made a new high. So that is something that is significant and important. The only thing is we do have a bearish candle, which means that last week the sellers did kind of win the battle, right? So that's just something, again, to be aware of. Now, me personally, I wouldn't trade this market this week because the overall momentum is bearish, but we've rejected. So I personally would like to see more confirmation before actually looking to see if I can find some good positions to actually trade this market, right? That's me personally. And the fact that it's not one of my favorites. But otherwise, let's just go down to the daily and let's see. So let's just go back onto this. So the only thing with what you've sent, okay, is what we want to see is we want to see the higher time frame stuff. Okay, we want to see the higher time frame stuff, because this is all well and good, okay, and you're going with the order flow, which is absolutely perfect. But what you do need to mark out is you need to see what's above the price, where the price is potentially reaching for, what's going to be in the way, etc., etc. So this Recent high was 0.7580, which is roughly where we are right now. Okay, so what we do need to be aware of is we have this order block here, which sent the market. This is a daily order block. But this order block here, which sent the market down to this low. Okay, we also breached that low right there. Okay, and now we've retraced and pulled back up into this region. So yes, the bullish pressure is in play right now. We had a very strong bullish day, which I know you caught good moves on. Would I still be buying this now at this point? No, I wouldn't. Now, just going back to your one, you have highlighted the right areas. Order block, 1 hour. Yeah, that's fine. So on the daily, I'd be very, very careful with this now because we're certainly at a point where last week we had bearish pressure. We've retraced back up to this region and now we just need to be a little bit careful because if the sellers want to regain control, where are they going to regain it from? Here. Okay, they're going to regain it from right where we are, maybe 0.76. So just be careful of that. As you can see, 4 hour time frame, we've got bullish order flow. So if I just go on to and draw those for you, so you can see every time we make that slight new high, we come back, we retest. Every time we make that slight new high, that one didn't actually make it, but there. You can see the bullish order flow though, right? We're pushing up. But would I buy it now? No, I wouldn't, okay? Because now we're coming up to a point of resistance or a point of supply, whatever you want to call it. And therefore, we do just want to be a little bit careful as this region could be a catalyst for shorts, okay? Now, the only reason we would short this market is if we saw something like break of structure, pull back, maybe another break of structure, pull back, and then we want to look for entries. Now, we can look for entries here, but it's a little bit more risky. But otherwise, that's the kind of move we'd look for if we were looking for shorts. Regarding buys, I wouldn't personally look for buys on this market right now, okay? So that's my kind of thought process on that. Otherwise, though, your hourly analysis, let me just jump onto that. You've marked out the levels correctly. You've also marked out new high was made, it's come back, it's retested this region perfectly. New high was made, it's come back and retested this region perfectly, which I know you've got those two marked out. So you've got this one and this one. So just this one here, if you're gonna highlight, actually you've got 4 hour written there. Let me just see what that 4 hour is, 1 second. So this is the hour. And then if I just go on to the 4 hour, okay, yeah, you've got the 4 hour one. That's fine. So you've got that one. That's fine. Yeah, no worries at all. If you look on the hour, my robot's placed another position. If you look on the hour, you can probably use this entire candle here because that was a nice feed into a low to push higher, right? So there's definitely orders coming in here in the opposite direction first to grab the liquidity, and then boom, we took off. And then we came back, retested, and then boom, we took off, okay? And then again, we've got this one here, which I think you've already got marked out. So again, just drag that across, boom, there's your retest, there's your liquidity, and boom, off you go again. So even today, if you were looking at buys, okay, buys would be okay at this level, but if we break this level, okay, then we need to look at a scenario like this potentially. So CADCHF, I'm gonna just mark that yellow. But otherwise, the analysis is good. Just remember, the screenshots that I want to see from you guys are the weekly, the daily, and maybe even the 4 hourly. So as we can see, the next one that David's done here is good in terms of we've got those higher time frames, right? So that's good. So let's have a look. So we've got GJ weekly. I love the candle, the color of the candles, man. Really love it. I actually really like just the white and black. I feel it's very, very clear. And charts, the way that you've marked them all are really nice as well. Really, really nice as well. Okay, so we've got weekly time frame. Let me just see what you read. So I'm bullish on GJ, very mindful of this 162.578 level. Both GBP and JPY seem quite weak at the moment. JPY a little bit more agreed. So it makes it a little harder to trade with. Yeah, absolutely. So GBP in general, GA dropping very, very hard. GBP CAD, dropping very, very hard. GBP/CHF has probably gone up ish, but kind of moving sideways because CHF. GJ is the one we're about to look at, and then GN is bearish as well. So yeah, like you say, most GBP pairs are bearish. GU is actually a little bit higher. This was yesterday's position, which is actually really annoying, because we got stopped out by 3 pips. So yeah, most GBP pairs are bearish. Most GBP pairs are bearish. So let's have a look at JPY. So yeah, mindful of that 162.578 level. My bot is going crazy today. 162.578. So let me just have a look at what you've done. So we've got obviously bullish momentum on the weekly. First weekly target is this weekly wick there. That's okay. Yep, we've broken the high already this week. GJ on the daily. Yeah, I love the fact that you're looking for that little pullback there down to that 160-odd level. Kilo must be broke for any chance of targeting some high. Correct. Yeah, your analysis and your charts are so clear. So it doesn't actually surprise me that you've been doing very, very well. Yes, you had a hiccup. We all have hiccups. But it doesn't surprise me that you're doing very well, because the way that your charts are laid out are so clear for people to see. I might even steal this white-black kind of theme, because personally I think it just looks really clear, really clean, and that's really, really important. If you want to analyze properly and really have an understanding of what this market is doing, then what you want to do is you want to have the cleanest charts you possibly can that make real sense to you. Okay, so GJ looking for that 160.5, and you did mention the 162.578 level. Okay, so let's go. So GJ, so GJ. So nice big dig for liquidity, nice big push up with the buyers winning, and then slowly but surely you've been now attempting to break those highs. Okay, we're almost at that level that you marked there as well, 162.161. But you did mention a level which is 162.578. So I'm guessing this is on another time frame that we're looking at here. I'm just gonna mark it on, so it's around here, just so I can see. So the first thing I would do, as always, is last week's high, last week's low. Now we've already obviously breached that higher, we're already pushing higher. I would certainly be aware of the liquidity around this region. Okay, I would definitely be aware of that, especially with GBP being weak. But for now, as you mentioned, JPY is relatively weak across the board. So AJ up, EJ is up, GJ we're on, NJ is gonna be up as well. Yeah, so overall weekly wise, JPY is weakening. Okay, which is good to support your vision and your bias, right? So that's what I'd be marking on this one here on the weekly. This is just here because I want to see what this level is. Okay, so nice low created, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we had this swing here, then we had the failure to break the low. Okay, failure to break the low on those daily. We are now also, I'm just seeing what, okay, that was just that liquidity. So let me just mark this. So we're sitting at this liquidity point now. So I'd definitely be a little bit careful around this point, because as we know, it has failed, but it does look like the fact that we're failing to break lows around here, it does look like we are gonna hopefully continue to push to the upside, right? So you're 162.57 level is here, which I'm guessing I'm still needing to go down time frames to see it, but I'm guessing it's something to do with maybe this kind of level in here as well, but I will have a look. Overall bullish, what would I personally be looking at? Well, Monday's gone now and we already had a big push, so we're not gonna get these pullbacks down to here. I would love to see the market come back down into this level, okay, which is roughly what you've done as well. If I just go into here, I'm pretty sure, yeah, 160.5 to 160, which is literally what I've just highlighted, 160.5 to around 160, yeah. So that's the daily. So I'd like to see the market come into there to look for buyers. And then if we just go on to the 4-hourly one, so now I will probably be able to see that level, 162.57. So yeah, you'll have to explain to me the 162.57 level. just because I can't see it on these time frames. But of course, we have this here, which is kind of the beginning of that downward move. So we can kind of refine that. We can delete what we had previously and we can sort of refine that there. We've already in that liquidity bit, we're already pushing and making new highs, and we already have that kind of opportunity for entry, which is going to be probably somewhere around here. Just keep it a big range because I like to see what happens within these regions. But yeah, definitely be looking at the same thing. We've already grabbed this liquidity here as well. So hopefully we can get a little bit of a pullback and a little bit of relief. But otherwise then we've got this kind of opportunity here to the upside, right? So GJ bullish, I'm quite happy to consider that bullish. I think the analysis that you've done there is really, really good. I love how your charts look as well. And I love the patience that you've got with those as well. So that is all the charts that I got come through. Yeah, that's all the charts that I actually got come through. Matthias, I'd like to see GBP USD. That's fine, I'll do GU now. I think because you probably just saw the tag and didn't quite see the messages before, in future, what you can do is you can just send me through your weekly analysis, okay? And then we can go from there and actually start to have a look at these things together to help you guys understand my thought process and see if things match up. But mostly, I think everybody's actually matches up. The only one was the CAD-CHF one, which just for me, I personally just don't like it for a trade. Maybe I'm biased and I don't even like that market anyway. That could also be one of the reasons. But yeah, so that's that. So let's jump into... Let's just give a quick bit of analysis on DAXI. So we've already done 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, we've done 4 markets so far. So weekly time frame on DXY. I'm just going to talk through these because I know these have been quite long. So bearish, kind of would expect continued bearish movement this week. Maybe we can pull into this kind of wick here. This would be the level I'd be kind of targeting for short positions. If we go onto the daily time frame, bearish order flow. Okay, so even last night's bit of manipulation, there has potentially just pulled us straight into this level here, okay, which is the previous order block on the daily, right? So it might actually fuel that downside move even further. If we go on to the 4-hour time frame, we can try to find an order block to work from. So we've got this one, which we haven't actually really tapped into, not really. And then we've also got this one here as well. So yeah, this one's gonna be a tricky one, but this bit of manipulation could literally be the fuel to actually take this market lower. Okay, that's kind of what I'm seeing here. That could be the fuel to take this market lower. Remember, I think it's a busy week this week. I think we've got FOMC and I think we've got FOMC, and I think we've got non-farm payrolls as well. Just bear with me whilst I find it. So any of you guys that use this, take off the low. You can even take off the medium if you want. I don't mind. I like to see some of the medium ones just to see how busy the days are. Today got some CAD news, some Euro news. So busy week for CAD this week. So tomorrow we've got CAD news, interest rate decisions. Busy week on Euro, busy week on CAD. And then if I can just get Friday included in this as well. Just get Friday included in that as well. So Thursday, non-farm payroll coming up on Friday, and then boom. So USD is going to be mental on Friday. Little bit of news coming out on Thursday as well with USD, and then apart from that, it's kind of CAD and Euro. So there is a lot of news this week. Yeah. So yeah, I would be kind of looking and focusing on this kind of movement here on DXY, which would mean that we are bearish on DXY, which would also then mean that we are potentially long on GBP USD. If I just go onto the weekly time frame for GU, as we can see, we've got a nice pullback actually, which could give us some good opportunities. And I'm just literally looking at my bot in the corner of my eye right now. I'll give you guys a little sneak preview. So it takes a lot of positions. Does take a lot of positions, but they're well managed. And as you can see there, it's literally turned it, if those of you that saw the Instagram, literally turned it on last night. And now it's just going to tick away and hopefully generate some good gains for the week. So I'm excited to get this up and running fully. At the moment, it's just kind of like that testing phase for me, because I want to optimize everything as much as I possibly can. I also wanted to trade as many markets as possible, simply because I want the diversification factor there as well. So, but the best thing is waking up in the morning and seeing that something's been trading overnight for you. And as you can see, generating some really, really good gains. So yeah, GU weekly. So that's our bullet. That's our kind of target for the week. Not target, but that's our objective, to smash through that. If we go into the daily time frame, we have just about pulled into that daily order block there as well, which is quite interesting. So that could be a good opportunity on there. If we go onto the 4-hour time frame, we can maybe refine this. Again, it's gonna depend on what dollar's gonna do first. But we've got this order block here, which is interesting. But then we've also got, it's the hourly anyway, I need for this. So we've also got this kind of low that was plugged in here as well, which is actually the first bit of liquidity that we grabbed at the beginning of this week. We've then got this kind of bit here. So GU longs are actually looking like they could potentially be a good shout. We just need to make sure that DXY was not a sort of flip reverse type aspect. We wanted to make sure that it was manipulation, as opposed to it actually being genuinely bullish. But based on structure, as I've already shown you guys, I think that will be the case. I'll move this big daily one now, and then what we can kind of expect to see is maybe a push from this level. If we do want to go deeper, then we do obviously have the push from this level. Cool. We do obviously have that push from this level here as well. Okay, so there's two areas there, maybe even three, but again, we'll wait and see what happens. But the price is making slightly higher highs at the minute, which is obviously great to see. So that's GU. Let me just double check that no one else said anything. CAD, CHF, GJ done, GU done. Mohammed, you were supposed to do gold for me, my man. GJ, I've jumped the gun too early. Does it look like an okay trade? So you got a 30 minute time frame there. Let's have a quick look. So GJ on the hourly, I'm just going to focus on the hourly. Yes, we've come into the right point. Okay, that's the first thing to note. Yes, we've come into the right point. The only thing I'm just a little bit wary of is the fact that we've just stabbed into that liquidity that I did just speak about. If we put on the previous daily highs and daily lows, we are quite high as well. So if I was personally going to look at entering that market, I would need to see more buyers coming in first. At the minute, that 30 minute candle is not enough. The 15 minute candle didn't even close below this point. So really what I'd like to see is maybe it digs for liquidity first, but then I want to see that bullish pressure. I actually want to see some bullish pressure, because right now on this hourly time frame, it's actually like a short-term bearish order flow, right? So we're creating those lower highs, lower lows, etc., etc. So I'll be a little wary of that position. I'm not saying it's not in the right place, because it is, and we've rejected that nicely, but it's just the buying pressure hasn't come through yet. But it might just be the fact that it's just a little bit early. It is only 6:20 in the UK. UK markets aren't even open yet. There's literally what they call mozzies, biters, whatever they're called. I'd just be a little wary of that. But David's typing now, he seems to be the GJ king. So that's GU. Let's just have a quick look at gold as well. So if we're expecting downside movements and downside momentum on DAXI, then what can we expect on gold? We can expect pushes to the upside. So here's our high that we are expecting to push and break. We've got daily, finding some sort of support and some sort of level around here, but there's nothing apparent on the daily just yet. If we go on the 4 hour though, we'll probably be able to see it. And what we can see is we can see this kind of level around here, which is where the market is currently holding up. Now this order block is absolutely massive, so I wouldn't use that, okay? I would then go down to the hourly time frame, and I'd start to look at something more like this, okay? And you see how the precision really comes through when you do this. Now also be aware that we grab liquidity to the high there, we grab liquidity to the low there. Currently we've got this kind of bearish order flow coming into this market. So maybe we'll get that manipulation down here, okay? But if we, for example, fail to kind of break the demand that we have around here, if we do break the demand here, then yeah, I think we can start to head higher. And there's some good sort of 200, 300 pip potential moves to come out of gold this week. So again, we'll have to look at dollar, focus on dollar a little bit. At the moment, we're seeing that kind of bearish push coming through after this level here, but we might come back and test that first, okay? Especially with this momentum, we might come back and test it first, so we'll have to wait and see. But overall, gold definitely bullish. So let's have a look. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7. I'm going to do one more market, which will be Aussie dollar CAD if it's interesting. So Aussie dollar CAD, there's the high we want to break because we've got nice bullish pressure and momentum. That's the area we need to be a little bit cautious of. Okay, that's the area we need to be a little bit cautious of because we've got that big wick. So there's a lot of sellers that came in and pushed that market down. If we go into the daily time frame, on the daily time frame, we are bullish order flowing up here. Okay, so definitely looking to break these kind of levels. And if we go into the 4 hour time frame, kind of stalling at this point at the moment, I reckon we'll probably come and grab this push up towards this level here, 9150. Just trying to sort of spot that ideal entry, which there isn't really much. So on the 4 hour, again, this is a very big candle, but on the 4 hour it's here. But on my weekly bias, I don't tend to look at the sort of daily stuff. Okay. The hourly stuff. I tend to focus on the weekly, daily, 4 hour. Okay. So anyway, guys, I've wrapped that up there. I hope you find that useful and a bit more interactive and interesting to see me go through some of your charts and things like that. Have a good week, and I'll speak to you guys soon.